Hey mate, I'm Alex.
And I'm Gason.
Welcome to Power Mates.
This is a place to learn and share about Fabric and Power Platform. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this channel with your friends and colleagues.
Well, Power Mate, today we are going to be talking about, from my perspective, a game changer, and we can't wait to dive in. The brand new Power Automate Desktop Copilot. So Copilot brings a whole new level of efficiency on Power Automate Desktop, making automation even more accessible.
Exactly. And for those who haven't explored it yet, Copilot is like having an AI-powered coding assistant right at your fingertips. It helps you build automation flows faster and smarter.
Yeah, and the best part, it's user-friendly. You know, whether you are a seasoned developer or just starting with automation, Copilot is designed to make the process seamless.
So, Alex, what are your initial thoughts on how this Copilot can impact our automation workflows?
Well, my friend, I have been experimenting with Copilot, and it's incredible how it understands the context of what I am trying to achieve on some point. You know, it just has some actions, provide code snippet, and really accelerate the development process.
Absolutely. So now let's talk a little bit about practical applications. How do we envision, Alex, our community members, our PowerMates community, leverage Copilot in their automation process? And, you know, for me, that I am not anything around coding, you know me. So do you think that Copilot can help me also as a learning tool?
Great question. And yes, I see Copilot, again, being a game changer for automating repetitive tasks, you know, data processing, and even more complex workflows. So it is a valuable asset for boosting productivity and efficiency. But let's go over my machine and let's see how it works so you can see how easy it is effectively to use and how to start working with it.
Yeah, sounds great.
Okay. So, as you can see here, I just has opened the Power Automate Desktop application. It's not the Power Automate Cloud. It's a different tool. So if you don't have the Power Automate installed on your machine, you need to go over the Windows Store and download the Power Automate. So once you're here, you just click on New. Okay, of course, you need to log in with your Office 365 user. Could be your company or the personal one, and you need, because you need a Power Platform environment, of course, to use Power Automate. So then you click New Flow, gives a name, let's say PowerMate Flow, and click on Create. And that is going to open you the canvas for start designing your flow. So there's many actions that you can use with Copilot. I'm going to show today two different ones just to give you an example on how it works. So the first one is going to be for scripting, for example. In scripting, as you can see here, we have like five different types of scripting that you can use with Copilot. But just for demo purpose, let's see how it's worked with PowerShell, for example. So for example, for PowerShell, I click here. Of course, if I know where is the PowerShell script I want to run, I can type here the script or put in the name or whatever. If not, because I am not a PowerShell expert, or even because I don't want to start writing the PowerShell script, I can click on generate the script with Copilot. And so, okay, and what you want to do? Some task that is super repetitive on PowerShell is iterate to an Excel and do something. So let's click on iterate through an Excel sheet and see what happens. As you can see here, Copilot create for us a PowerShell script that opens a Excel file and a sheet one. So of course, if you need to get a specific file for a specific path, you need to write your path, you need to change the sheet name, but overall you have pretty complete a script to iterate through an Excel sheet. But let's say this is something for Gaston. I don't know what you think, but refresh Power BI dataset could be something interesting for you. Let's see what happens if we say, okay, generate a refresh for Power BI dataset, connect to my enterprise on-premise gateway. And as you can see here, let's write a script. Of course, need to import the module, so that's okay. Login into Power BI, get the workspace, get dataset, then refresh the dataset and log out. I don't know if the script it fully worked, but I think this is a good starting point if you need to refresh a dataset. So you just need to put your information. Of course, you are going to need to add here the dataset ID or the workspace ID as usual. So I think that is awesome. And the other one I want to show you today is for databases, for example, just databases here, databases. Okay, as you can see here, for execute SQL statement, we have the Copilot symbol, so we can use Copilot to create a SQL statement or script. So let's see that we want to, okay, I have one here to test. Select all the cars sold in 2023 for more than 25Ks. For the brand, I don't know, Toyota. So, and we can see here, it's a pretty simple query, of course, for those who know how to write SQL queries, but for those who have, no, I just use something in Excel my whole life. So it's pretty simple to create a SQL query for select all the cars sold on 2023 for the price more than 25Ks and the brand to show. And you can start, again, editing your query, editing your prompt, and do things more interesting at some point. And the last point I want to show you today with Power Automate Desktop is, okay, let's see that there's some others action that doesn't have Copilot, or maybe never is going to have the Copilot, but you can have here the Copilot for the entire Power Automate Desktop. So you can start asking questions. Let's say need to extract information from, oh my gosh, from a PDF file and store the info into a Microsoft Fabric layout, or say something. And that is not going to create for you the action like we have been seeing on the script side of things, but it's going to point you on how are the step by step that you need to follow to create those kind of flows, because you ask for a flow that needs to extract information from a PDF file and then store information in Fabric. So of course you're going to say, okay, need to start Power Automate Desktop, of course, and then have the extract information action. So you have the step-by-step on how to achieve that. Of course, you need to figure it out when the Copilot say, add the extracted from PDF action, what is exactly the extract from PDF action. But is a good starting point on how to go step by step and create those kind of flows.
That is awesome, Alex. And one thing, as we wrap up from this video, I would love your advice for, you know, our community on any kind of final thoughts or tips for our community members diving for the first time into this new world around Copilot.
First thing is, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to experiment and let Copilot guide you. No, it's a tool that empowers you to automate with confidence at some point, because nothing happens if you try to use that. So as more you use it, more you will appreciate its capabilities, you know?
Yeah, fantastic advice from your end. Kind of from my end, let's say, and as a summary here, just embrace the Copilot experience, just going out there, explore the features, elevate your automation game.
That's right. So the empowerment, that's all for today.
Stay tuned for more in-depth insights, tutorial, and exciting news right here in our channel.
As usual, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, like our videos, and join us on this journey.
As we usually say, together, let's unlock the full potential on our Power Platform and Microsoft Fabric.
Yeah.